Hello all, today we will be creating a ball that bounces all around the screen. This is a very primitive thing to make. It's very simple and it requires no prior knowledge from you. So first, in processing there are two methods, void setup and void draw. In the setup is what starts when you begin the code. The draw just loops on 60 times a second, unless you say so otherwise, but we're not going to get into that. So in the setup, I'm going to set the size to 1050 by 800. That, or actually no, I'm going to make it something like 500 by 500. So if I just play that, this is what's going to show up. Right? So it's blank and gray. So to start off, I'm going to make the background black. And I'm going to draw a circle. So that's ellipse right in the middle of the screen. And that's half of this and half of that. I could write 250 by 250. Instead, I'm going to show you a shortcut, which is just width divided by 2 and height divided by 2, which makes a computer do the math. We don't have to do it. Then you set the width and height of the circle. I'm just going to keep it constant, so 50 and 50. That's my circle, and it should be right in the center of the screen. There we go. I'm going to set this to be a red circle. There we go. So, what I'm going to do next is to replace these x, y, width, and height parameters with integers. So, integer x. You can make up any name for them, but this is what I'm going to call them. Integer width, integer height. These are basically boxes to store your numbers, right? And in setup, I'm going to say what x is equal to. I could write it here, but it's better in setup. You'll see why. X is equal to width divided by 2. Y is equal to height divided by 2. Width is equal to 50, height is equal to 50, and let's put that in. All I'm doing is replacing, and if I play this, it will be the exact same thing as before, right? Why did I do this? Well, in order to make it move. If I were to, in order to move the ellipse to the right, I'd have to increase the right, every time it loops. So every time it loops, it's going to increase by 1. And it loops this thing, this whole void draw, loops 60 times a second. So it's going to move about 60 units, 60 pixels to the right per second. Let's see it. Yep, there we go. As you can see, it's leaving a trail. And this is because you must, unless you want the trail, you must put the background into draw. Why? Because what this does is color the whole background, but we want it to, but only once if we leave it here. But in draw, it does it over and over and over again, clearing out what was before every time it loops. So, see, as you can see, the trail is gone. The order really matters in processing. If I put the background after my code, you're not going to see anything. Because there is an ellipse, there is a circle, and it is moving, but it's behind the background. So the order really matters. Alright? And what we're going to do next is actually make it bounce back. So when it hits the right side of the screen, it bounces back. As you can see, right now, it goes, it goes, it goes, it goes, and it keeps going forever. The x just keeps increasing. If I wanted to bounce back, I'm going to have to write an if statement. So, actually before I do that, I'm going to replace the 1 here with a variable called speed. You can call it anything you want. It's just an integer variable. Again, I'm going to set it to 1. Or I could make it faster, 2. So, just let's see it. This is what we have. It's just going to go on infinitely. So in order to check if the circle is too far to the right, we need to make an if statement. So if the x is greater than the width, then we are going to make speed equal to negative speed. So if it was going 40 to the right, it's now going to go negative 40 to the right, which is the same as going 40 to the left, correct? And if I play that, then it's just going to bounce back once. See? And it never goes back. It just keeps going left because we haven't set an if statement to make it go back. So what I'm going to do is else, otherwise, if the x is less than 0, which is the left side of the screen, that's the x coordinate of the left side of the screen, then I'm going to make speed equal to negative speed. So if it was negative before, now it's going to be positive. So if it was going left before, now it's going right. So let's see it. Goes right, bounces, and that, and it keeps doing that over and over again. As you can see, it's just half of the circle goes through the screen, and that's because what our program does is actually draw the circle from the center point. That's what ellipse does by nature. So in order to, since it's half of the width, we could either calculate that this is, I don't know, minus 25, this is plus 25, so with minus 25, this would work. See, why 25? Because it's exactly half of the width value that we set it here. Or we could do a shortcut, which is just width divided by 2. The shortcut is always better, because if we decide to change the width of it, the code will still work. So if I made it 100, this will still work. See? In any case, for now it's just 50. Now we're going to do the exact same thing for the y. So if the y is greater than the height, minus h divided by 2, then speed equals negative speed. And I'm going to copy that. Actually, I'm going to copy this. Else if y, Okay, as now we're dealing with the x and y, so we can't use the same speed anymore. I'm going to rename the speed variable to speed x, so it's just the speed for the x. Now I'm going to create a new one called speed y. So that's the speed of the... Actually, it's nothing right now. This is nothing until I set it. So speed... I'm just changing all the previous speeds to speed x's. So this. And since this is y now, speed y, I'm just going to make it equal to 3 actually. Speed y. Of course, speed x. Okay, so it's still going to work the same way because we had. Look. Because this is the thing that actually moves the code. And this is just checking if it is at a certain point. But since the y is not moving, there's nothing to check. So I'm just going to add. The same thing, y equals y plus speed y. And this should work perfectly fine. And there we have it, a ball bouncing around the screen. It's probably a lot to digest, but I don't expect anyone to know, any beginner to understand this in the first go. If you do, then congratulations, really. I guess now that we're done making the program, we can try to shorten the script a little. The more short it is, the more efficiently it'll run, or the less memory it'll use. So I'm just gonna, this is a shortcut. Since they're all integers, we can just make a comma. It's just still going to set them, but there we go. I made all of that one line, and it's still going to work the same way. And of course I don't need this. And oh yeah, I forgot. We're going to add, just to introduce you to methods, we're going to organize the script a little bit. It's probably not for the sake of efficiency, it's more for organizing. So what I'm going to do is create a new void. I can call it anything I want. I'm just going to call it void draw circle. Right? I'm making this right now. I'm just going to put all of this stuff in draw circle. And I'm going to replace this with just draw circle. So what this does is it goes to draw circle, since the code is read from top to bottom, goes to draw circle, it goes here, it reads this line, then it goes back here and continues these. And now I'm going to put these into a new one. I'm going to call it move circle, and I'm going to set it here, void move circle, and I'm going to put these in. Of course, feel free to call them whatever you want. This is just for the sake of example. I'm going to create the last one to put the if statement, so void bounce off, I don't know, since all this piece of code, all it does is make the ball, check if the ball is off the screen, and then bounce it off. So bounce off, and this is all there is in our draw. Nothing, unless it is called, it does not exist. At least the computer does not read it, so it needs to be called, and it's called in this order. Or yeah, if my bad, very silly mistake, it's a typo. I forgot to say that you need to put a semicolon after every statement, in case you haven't realized that. As you can see, it's still working the same way, but the draw feels more English. First I'm telling it to draw the circle, then I'm telling it to move the circle, then I'm telling it to bounce off the walls. But say if I came 20 years later to look at this code and I forgot how to speak English. No, that's not what I meant. If I forgot what I meant, I don't know. So you can add comments to your code. Comments are not read by the program, so this is a way to start a comment. Double slash. Right? So if I type in, it turns gray for our convenience. So, hello, my name is. This stuff will not be read by the computer. It'll be entirely ignored. If I don't put that there, it turns black and doesn't work, of course. If I wanted to comment off a line, say I didn't want it to move anymore, I could. It's a simple way to comment out stuff without actually deleting it, so you can always call it back later on. So now it doesn't move since I stopped calling the move circle function. All it does is it goes from draw circle to bounce off, and then loops again and again and again. And lastly, if you wanted to, there's another type of comment. This one comments not just one line, but this one is more flexible basically. It's slash star, and to end it you do star slash, so the opposite. And what this is going to do is obviously not play any of these. The only one being played is draw. Again, if you wanted to remove the background here, and if you put it back in setup, so I'm going to do it the comment way so I don't have to keep copying and pasting it, background zero. If I did that, as you can see, it leaves a trail because it never clears out the old frames. And this is just repeating over and over again. And it's going to create a neat pattern, which is pretty cool. Processing is great for making patterns by accident. So So this is a continuously repeating pattern. Anyways, I'm going to comment that out and put that back in. There. So in this video, we looked over how to create variables, the difference between setup and draw, how to use methods, how to create if statements, how to create even else if statements, and that's about it. I hope you enjoyed. Have a good day.